Hi, my name is Osama Naga. We'll start discussing in this video the management of dehydration, fluids, and electrolytes. You can follow with me in the pediatric board study guide. This video is a supplement to the renal disorder chapter, starting from page 371 to page 392. My objective in this presentation is to know the management of different types of dehydration, recognize the different clinical and laboratory abnormalities in the isonatremic, hyponatremic, and hypernatremic dehydration and electrolyte imbalance. Common IV fluids used in the hospital for fluid and electrolyte replacement. First one is D5W, 5% dextrose in water. It has 5 gram of sugar per 100 ml. It is usually combined with normal saline or half normal saline or quarter normal saline. The next one is D10W, which is 10% dextrose in water. It has 10 gram of sugar per 100 ml, commonly used in neonates in the first few days, and may be combined later with quarter normal saline if they require IV fluid. Also can be used for the cases of hypoglycemia as well. Normal saline is isotonic solution commonly used as volume expander, used for boluses and in cases of emergencies. It has 154 mg of sodium, does not have potassium or sugar. Have normal saline, it has half the amount of 154, which is 77 mg per liter. Quarter normal saline, it has 34 mg of sodium per liter. 3% normal saline is hypertonic solution. It has 513 of sodium per liter. And this type of fluid used in the cases of emergency, for example, in cases of symptomatic hyponatremia or in cases of severe hyponatremia. Lactated ringers is another volume expanders commonly used as boluses also as well. It has 0 to 10 gram of sugar per 100 ml, and it has 130 mg of sodium per liter. It is hypotonic compared to the normal saline, and also it has potassium. And normal saline is much more preferred to be used in as a bolus more than the lactated ringers, because this can be associated with electrolyte disturbance and hyperkalemia. It's very important to be familiar with the clinical signs and symptoms of dehydration, classification of dehydration to mild, moderate, and severe. Children with mild dehydration, they are clinically stable. They may present with increased thirst, decreased urine output, and the mucous membrane is tacky or sticky. The moderate dehydration, the child is irritable, decreased urine output to less than 1 ml per kilogram per hour, mucous membrane is dry, skin turgor is reduced, capillary refill is mildly delayed, and the skin temperature is cool, anterior fontanelle sunken, heart rate increased, the blood pressure normal to low, respiration deep or may be increased. Severe dehydration, the child is much worse, is lethargic, decreased urine output or even absent. Mucous membrane is extremely dry or parched. The skin turgor is tinting, and in cases of hypernatremic dehydration, the skin will be doughy. The capillary refill is markedly delayed, more than 2 seconds. Skin temperature cool, mottled, or clammy, especially in cases of shock. Anterior fontanelle markedly sunken. Heart rate markedly increased, or even worse than that will be low. Blood pressure is low, and this is a late presentation in cases of dehydration and is considered emergency, requiring immediate volume expanders and boluses. Respirations deep, increased, or even worse than that is decreased or absent. Know that in cases of hyponatremic dehydration, these symptoms will be more pronounced and is easy to identify. And the cases of hypernatremic dehydration with high sodium level in the serum, because of the intravascular fluid will be hypertonic, this will cause shift of the fluid from the cells to the intravascular space and cause late presentation and less pronounced sign of dehydration. So you may need to add 3 to 5% to this table in the cases of hypernatremic dehydration. Also be familiar with the best predictors of dehydration is a skin turgor, capillary fill, and respirations. Again, the best predictors of at least 5% dehydration is prolonged capillary fill more than 2 seconds, abnormal skin turgor, and abnormal respiratory pattern. This is the best three signs or best predictors of at least 5% dehydration or more: prolonged capillary fill, abnormal skin turgor, abnormal respiratory pattern. This table is for rapid assessment to help you to remember how to rapidly assess a child with dehydration. Mild dehydration, the child will be hemodynamically stable, no changes in vital signs. So this is a 5% dehydration, and the fluid deficit here will be 50 ml per kilo. And if in cases of adolescence is 3%, which is 30 ml per kilo. Moderate dehydration, the child will have tachycardia, and this will be a 10% dehydration, and the how to replace for the deficit is 100 ml per kilo gram. And the in cases of adolescent will be 6%, and how to replace for the deficit is 60 ml per kilo. Severe cases of dehydration, the blood pressure will be low, so it will be hypotension and with impaired perfusion, and this will be 15% dehydration, and the replacement of the deficit is 150 ml per kilogram. And the in cases of adolescent will be 9%, and the replacement will be 90 ml per kilogram. Know about capillary fill. Capillary fill should be less than 2 seconds normally. Capillary fill more than 2 seconds indicate dehydration, shock, hypothermia, or peripheral vascular disease. So be familiar with capillary fill. And how to do it? By applying pressure on the nail against the nail bed, and this will make the under the nail whiten, and it should, the when you release the pressure, the color should come back immediately. If it's 2 seconds or more than 2 seconds, it indicates dehydration, shock, hypothermia, or peripheral vascular disease. So normally it should be less than 2 seconds. Laboratory testing for dehydration. It is not indicated to do electrolyte level for patients you are managing as outpatient with oral rehydration. It is indicated if IV fluid is required, usually if more than 10% dehydration. When you are doing the lab, the best thing to look at, or the most sensitive test to look at, is the serum bicarb. This will give you the level of dehydration and differentiate between mild and moderate to severe cases of dehydration. Level less than 17 is an excellent predictor or indicator of moderate to severe dehydration. Sodium level is very important to identify, and this will help you to choose the best IV fluid and the rate of repletion or replacement. Potassium level generally is low in cases of dehydration, but when you do the lab, the value can be normal, low, or high, but this does not reflect the actual value or the actual content of the potassium in the body. So you have to consider that. When you give the IV fluid and correct the acidosis, even if the value is high, the potassium level can be normal or low afterward. So you have to keep that in mind. And you have to correct also the potassium level for the degree of the acidosis. Metabolic acidosis is expected in cases of diarrhea and usually normal anion gap because of loss of bicarb from the stool. And in severe cases, the child might develop lactic acidosis because of poor tissue perfusion, and this can make the anion gap elevated. Metabolic alkalosis is expected in cases of vomiting because of loss of acid from the stomach. And this is a classic presentation, especially in the cases of pyloric stenosis. Outpatient management of dehydration. It is not appropriate and not recommended to use plain water, juices, Sprite, 7-Up for rehydration of a patient with dehydration. The appropriate fluid to use is oral rehydration solution or Pedialyte or similar fluids. Sport drinks is not recommended. So the oral rehydration solution, it has the appropriate ratio of sodium to glucose for the best and maximum absorption through the intestinal lumen. The recipe of oral rehydration solution is 1 liter of water, 2 level of tablespoon of sugar or honey, a quarter teaspoon of table salt, and a quarter teaspoon of baking soda. Remember, you cannot use honey in a child less than 1 year. So sugar will be the option if a child less than 1 year of age. So a combination of that, this will give you oral rehydration solution. If you can add flavor also to make it more palatable, like have a cup of orange juice or coconut water. Very important to know that mild to moderate dehydration can be managed as outpatient, especially if the child is stable and able to drink. So the ability to drink is the key. So step number one, if the child is vomiting, give 2 ml per kilo of ORS for each episode of vomiting. If diarrheal stool, give 10 ml per kilogram of ORS for each diarrheal stool to replace for ongoing losses. The next one, to replace for the deficit, deficit replacement with ORS. Give 50 ml per kilo over 4 hours in mild dehydration. Give 100 ml per kilo over 4 hours in moderate dehydration. Step number 3, maintenance phase. Breastfeeding formula should be resumed as soon as possible. The infant should be given as much as they want, as frequent as they want, in cases of vomiting and diarrhea. This is the best management. And the children should continue their regular diet. No restriction. No specific diet to be restricted. This is much better and make the child, the condition resolve quicker. No bowel rest. No bread diet. Also restrict juices or sugary drinks, which may make the diarrhea worse and may cause electrolyte disturbance in cases of vomiting because of the high osmolarity and an appropriate proportion of sugar and salt in this type of liquids. Do not give up oral rehydration. Oral rehydration is the best and much preferred than IV fluid. Use a spoon, syringe, dropper. Tell the parents to do their best to continue giving oral rehydration. Nasogastric tube can be used in the patient with severe vomiting or oral ulcer, like in cases of herpa angina. So oral fluid is much better than IV fluid. Ondansetron or Zofran or other anti-emetics can be used in cases of severe vomiting. This can reduce the need for IV therapy and hospital admission. So do not give up oral rehydration. As much as oral rehydration is highly recommended and encouraged, we have to know when the oral rehydration is contraindicated and when to go for IV fluid or hospital admission. Circulatory instability, hypotension or shock, altered mental status, intractable vomiting, bloody diarrhea, ileus, abnormal serum sodium. It is not appropriate to correct hyponatremia or hypernatremia with oral rehydration solution, glucose malabsorption. Management of severe cases of dehydration require a bolus of isotonic fluids, 20 ml per kilo over 10 to 15 minutes, by giving normal saline. It is preferred over the lactated drinkers because it is isotonic. It does not have potassium. Lactated drinkers, it has potassium and is hypotonic and is not preferred as normal saline. Normal saline is your best option. Indication for bolus if the child is unstable regardless the type of dehydration, symptomatic dehydration, shock or near shock. You may repeat the bolus 20 ml per kilogram until the vital signs, perfusion and capillary refill normalize. If no response after two boluses of isotonic fluids or if there acute blood loss, you can use colloid fluids, for example albumin, blood or plasma, 10 ml per kilo. So again, you can repeat the bolus if the child is still not responding until the vital signs, perfusion and capillary refill normalize. If the child is not improving after 60 to 80 ml per kilo of isotonic crystalloid boluses, for example, normal saline, consider other causes of shock, for example, sepsis, hemorrhage, or cardiac diseases. If the child is having seizure because of hyponatremia, you can give 10 to 12 ml per kilo of 3% normal saline over 30 minutes. This may stop the seizure. Also, if the child is having hypoglycemia, you can use the 10% dextrose and giving 2.5 ml per kilo as a bolus, or you can use the 25% dextrose and you give 1 ml per kilo as a bolus. Calculation of the maintenance IV fluid using holiday cigar method by using the body weight. The first 10 kilogram you multiply 100 ml per kilo per day. Second 10 kilo you multiply 50 ml per kilo per day. The each additional kilogram you multiply 20 ml per kilo per day, then the total of that you divide over 24 hours. This will give you the rate of the maintenance IV fluid per hour. Shortcut using the 4-2-1 method. You multiply the first 10 kilo time 4, then the second 10 kilo time 2, and each additional kilo afterward is time 1. For example, fluid rate of 10 years old boy weighing 30 kilogram, the 100 time the first 10 kilogram is 1000 ml, the 50 ml time the second 10 kilogram equal 500 ml, and the each additional kilo afterward you multiply by 20, so 20 times 10 is equal 200 ml per day. The total of that 1000 plus 500 plus 200 is 1700 divided by 24 hours. So the IV fluid rate of the maintenance is 70 ml per hour. Shortcut, you will use the 4-2-1 method. 4 times 10 is 40, 2 times 10 is 20, 1 times 10 is 10. So 40 plus 20 plus 10 is 70. So the maintenance IV fluid rate directly is 70 ml per hour. This is a shortcut and fast to calculate the maintenance IV fluid. Calculation of sodium maintenance is 3 mg per 100 ml of maintenance IV fluid. So if you are giving 1000 ml maintenance, so the will be 3 per 100 ml. So will be 3 times 10 equal 30. This is the maintenance of sodium. The maintenance of potassium is 2 mg per 100 ml. So if you have a child with 1000 ml of maintenance IV fluid, you need to give 20 mg of potassium to be added to the maintenance IV fluid per 24 hours. Fluid deficit, percentage of dehydration times the body weight. Ideally, the weight before the illness is the one you use. So if you have it, use the weight before the illness. So for example, if a child weighing 7 kg with 10% dehydration, you multiply 7 times 100, so the deficit here is 700. If the child weighing 7 kg and with 15% dehydration, you do 7 times 150 equal 1050. So this is how to calculate the fluid deficit. Electrolyte deficit, this table to help us to understand the formulas we will use for calculation of electrolyte deficit. The extracellular fluid space mainly contain sodium. The intracellular fluid space mainly contain potassium. And if you have the illnesses less than 3 days, mainly most of the fluid you will lose from the extracellular fluid space, and the 20% from the intracellular fluid space. And if the illness is 3 days or more, you will lose more fluid from the intracellular fluid space and, of course, containing potassium. So 3 days of illness or more, 60% from the extracellular fluid space and 40% from the intracellular fluid space. How to calculate sodium deficit? Sodium deficit is fluid deficit in liter, time 0.6 times 140. Where is the 0.6 came from? Is the 60% loss of fluid from the extracellular fluid space in a child ill 3 days or more. Where is the 140 came from? Is the level of the sodium in the extracellular fluid space. So the shortcut for that is 0.6 times 140 equal 84 per 1000 ml. To make it easier, you can say 8.4 per 100 ml fluid deficit. This is how to calculate. This is what you need to memorize. 8.4 per 100 ml. In this case, for example, a child is having 1000 ml deficit. 1000 ml, it has 1000. So because it's 8.4 per 100 ml fluid deficit is the sodium deficit. So you do 10 times 8.4 equal 84. So the sodium deficit in a child having 1000 ml fluid deficit is 84, because you multiplied the number of hundreds in the fluid deficit times the 8.4. Potassium deficit, fluid deficit in liter, time 0.4 times 150. 0.4 is the 40% loss of the fluid from the intracellular fluid space. The 150 is the level of the potassium in the intracellular fluid space. Shortcut for that, 0.4 times 150 equal 60. But this is per 1000 ml. To make it easier, 6 mg of potassium per 100 ml fluid deficit. This is what you need to memorize. So in this example, this patient is having 1000 ml fluid deficit. So 10 times 6 is 60. So the potassium deficit in this patient is 60 mg per liter. So remember what you need to memorize: 8.4 per 100 ml for the sodium, 6 mg per 100 ml fluid deficit for the potassium. And we'll understand that in the practice cases. It is acceptable practice by expert that you can give the total IV fluid including the maintenance and deficit over 24 hours in cases of isonatremic and hyponatremic dehydration, with no need to divide 50 and 50, first 50 over 8 hours and the second 50 over 16 hours. as recommended by some clinician, but this can be confusing and is not practical in real life. And also, sometimes the nurse may miss to change the IV fluid rate after 8 hours, and can be associated also with rapid replacement of fluid in the first 8 hours, and can be associated with complication. So over 24 hours total is easier, is practical, and is very safe. Replacement for ongoing losses is very important for vomiting and diarrhea. ml for ml. Know that each 1 gram loss of the body weight associated with 1 ml loss of water in cases of vomiting and diarrhea or fluid loss. The fluids that when you replace, you should use fluid that it has the same electrolyte composition. In cases of vomiting and nasogastric drainage, use have normal saline plus 10 to 15 mg per liter of potassium chloride. In cases of diarrhea, if the child is having severe acidosis, bicarb will be very helpful. Types of dehydration. When you decide for IV hydration, you will need to do electrolyte level, and if the sodium level is normal, this is isonatremic dehydration. Isonatremic dehydration, and the sodium level will be between 130 to 150. Common cause of that is secretory diarrhea. This is the most common type. Hyponatremic dehydration is less common, and the sodium level will be less than 130 mg per liter. This commonly associated if the child is dehydrated and replaced, for example, with plain water with no sugar or electrolyte, or replaced with inappropriate fluids, for example, juices, Sprite, Coca-Cola, or 7-Up. This type of fluid can cause a hypotonic or a hyponatremic dehydration. Also, if the child in the hospital and replaced with hypotonic solution, not appropriate for replacement of hyponatremic dehydration. Hypernatremic dehydration is the least common, and if the sodium level is more than 150 mg per liter, this is common with rotavirus infection and severe diarrhea. And also, this type of dehydration is very important to be taken seriously, and the type of fluid should be chosen, and the rate of the replacement of the fluid should be over 48 hours to avoid complications. This table is to summarize and differentiate between the management of different types of dehydration: isonatremic, hyponatremic, and hypernatremic. So to make it easy to understand the difference in our head when we are managing these patients. So in cases of isonatremic dehydration, which is the most common, is the easiest one. So first, to calculate the maintenance of fluids and electrolytes. Then you add to that the deficit of fluids and electrolytes, and the total divide over 24 hours. The next one is hyponatremic dehydration. There is an additional step here. The first step is similar to isonatremic, maintenance of the fluids and electrolytes. Then calculate the deficit of fluid and electrolyte. Also, the second step is similar to the isonatremic dehydration. The additional step here is to calculate the additional sodium deficit, because this is hyponatremic dehydration, so you need to give more sodium. So how to calculate that to avoid giving over or to overcorrection of the patient is a mix of sodium deficit. It will be equal desired sodium minus the measured sodium time 0.6 times the weight of the patient. The desired sodium always use 130 to avoid over correction. So you add the total of all of these and they divide the total volume over 24 hours. Hypernatremic dehydration is different. So the maintenance of fluid, fluids and electrolytes will be timed for 48 hours. So the maintenance will stay the same day by day. But the deficit is the one will divide over 48 hours. So here to avoid overcorrection and complication. So first thing to here calculate the deficit of fluids without electrolyte. If you see here is different, here with electrolyte, here is with electrolyte, here is without electrolyte. So deficit of the fluid. Then the next step is to calculate the free fluid deficit. You need to memorize this formula. It's very easy. 4 ml per kilo for each 1 mg of if the sodium level is more than 145. And 3 ml per kilo for each 1 mg if the sodium level is more than 170. And after getting the number from here, you subtract the fluid or the deficit of the fluid minus the free fluid deficit. So fluid deficit containing electrolyte will be equal fluid deficit minus the free fluid deficit. And you divide the total replacement over 48 hours. So the fluid will be given over 48 hours. So remember here, the maintenance fluid for each 24 hours is the same, but the difference here that you will divide the deficit over 48 hours to avoid overcorrection and complications. So you can write this formulas in your phone, on your iPad. So when you need it, you will be able to use it easily and able to calculate the fluid replacement for hypernatremic dehydration. This is very important to be done correctly to avoid complications. Again, to summarize the plan for the calculation of the isonatremic dehydration, you calculate the maintenance plus the deficit of the fluid and the electrolyte. So you do the total of both. So maintenance plus the deficit of the fluid and the electrolyte. Then you subtract the bolus if it was given. Then give the total over 24 hours. Generally, this will calculate to D5, one-third of normal saline plus 40 mg of potassium chloride, 40 mg per liter of potassium chloride. But because D5, one-third is not widely available in many hospitals, so it is acceptable and safely used for all the patients with isonatremic dehydration fluid, D5, and have normal saline plus 40 mg per liter of potassium chloride. So you need to use that, and just you need to calculate the rate of the fluid. So you can use D5 and have normal saline plus 40 mg per liter. This is the commonly used fluid used in the cases of isonatremic dehydration. Let's practice all these numbers in a clinical case scenario. This is a 10 months old infant with 4 days of frequent water stool. He is listless in his mother's arm. Physical examination is significant for dry mucous membrane. The skin is tinting and the heart rate is 160 per minute. Blood pressure is 80 over 40 millimeter of mercury. The weight during the illness is 9 kilogram. The weight before the illness is 10 kilogram. The serum sodium is normal, 138. And he was given 20 per kilo of bolus of normal saline, which is 200 ml were given IV. So the information we need to calculate the IV fluid for this patient is here. The weight before the illness is 10 kilogram, and the weight now is 9 kilograms. So 10 minus 9 is 1. So this patient lost 10% of the body weight. So therefore, the percentage of dehydration is 10%, and the sodium level is normal. So this is isonatremic dehydration. So based in Holliday-Seeger method, we will calculate the maintenance fluid. So the first 10 kilo, you give 100 ml per kilo, per kilogram. So 100 ml per kilogram equal 1000 ml. For the sodium, you will do 3 mg per 100 ml of the maintenance fluid. So 3 times 10 equal 30. And for the potassium, the same, you will do 2 per 100 ml of the maintenance fluid, and you have here 1000, and 1000, it has 1000 ml, so 2 times 10 equal 20. For the deficit, you will do, because this is 10%, you will do 100 times 10 kilogram and equal 1000 ml. For the sodium deficit is 8.4 mg per 100 ml of the fluid deficit, so 8.4 times 10 equal 84. Where did the 10 come from? Because the 1000 ml, it has 10 hundreds. And the potassium, 6 mg per 100 ml of the fluid deficit will be 6 times 10 equals 60. And you subtract the bolus you give. The bolus you give 200 ml. And the 200 ml of normal saline contains 30.8 mg of sodium. You can calculate that by considering 1000 ml, it contains 154 mg, so 200 will contain 30.8 mg of sodium, and of course there is no potassium in the bowls. And the total fluid here, 1000 plus 1000 minus 200 equal 1800, and you divide that by 24 hours will give you the rate 75 ml per hour. For the sodium, 30 plus 84 minus 30.8 will give you total of 83.2 mg of sodium required in 24 hours. And the potassium here, 20 plus 60 equal 80, required over 24 hours. So you need to divide this amount over the 1.8 because you have to divide this amount for each liter of bag you are preparing. So 80 divided by 1.8, so you round it to 40 mg per liter of IV bag you are preparing, 1000 ml bag of fluid. And also the 83 here you divide by 2, by 1.8, it will be 46. So 46 here is ideal fluid for that is D5 and third normal saline, because third normal saline will contain 51. So 51 to 46 is very close. So this is the ideal fluid you will give D5 and third normal saline plus 40 mg of potassium chloride to run at 75 ml per hour. Alternatively or safely, you can infuse D5 and have normal saline plus 40 mg of potassium chloride to run at 75 ml per hour over 24 hours. It can be given safely because this type of fluid, one third normal saline, is not widely available and is very acceptable to use D5 and a half. Another way to calculate the IV fluid for the same case, the weight is 10 kg and the weight after the illness is 9 kg. So 10 minus 9 equal 1. So this is a 10% dehydration and the sodium is normal. So this is isonatremic dehydration. For 10% dehydration, you double the maintenance. You give double the maintenance using the Halliday Seeger method, 4:1. So 10 kilogram times 4 equal 40 ml per hour. So double the maintenance is 80 ml per hour. So generally, this usually calculate to D5 third normal saline plus 40 mg of potassium chloride to run at 80 ml per hour. It is safe to use the alternative fluid, which is D5 and a half normal saline, which is widely available, more than one third of normal saline plus 40 mg of potassium chloride to run at 80 ml per hour. If you compare the rate 80 ml to the what we calculated in the previous slide, 75 ml per hour is very close. So you can use this method in isonatremic dehydration. 10%, double the maintenance. So conclusion of calculation of isonatremic dehydration, generally calculate to D5 third normal saline plus 40 mg potassium chloride per liter. So this is usually calculated to that, but can be safely substituted because this fluid is widely available in the hospital to D5 and a half normal saline plus 40 mg of potassium chloride. For the rate, you if the deficit is 5%, 1.5 maintenance. If it's 10%, double maintenance. If it's 15%, you do 2.5 to 3 maintenance. The maintenance plus the deficit volume can be infused over 24 hours. Hyponatremic dehydration, fluid replacement usually over 24 hours. You do the maintenance plus the deficit of fluid and the electrolyte deficit as we did before with isonatremic dehydration. You subtract the bolus if it was given. The additional step here to add the sodium deficit. So additional sodium should be added. So the mg of sodium deficit equal desired sodium minus measured sodium time 0.6 time the weight of the patient. So then you add all together and you give over 24 hours. Generally, this calculate to D5 and a half normal saline plus 40 mg per liter of potassium chloride. This is the shortcut. Clinical case scenario for calculation of hyponatremic dehydration. This is an infant with 4 days history of vomiting and diarrhea. His mother giving him only water in the last 2 days. So the water is hypotonic for a child having vomiting and diarrhea. So is expected to have a low sodium level. So his anterior fontanelle and eyes are sunken. The capillary refill is 4 to 5 seconds prolonged. And he has tachypnea, clear lung. Blood pressure is 55 over 34. And his current weight is 5 kilogram. His weight before the illness is 5.5 kilogram. So the sodium level is 120, is low. So this is hyponatremic dehydration. The estimated dehydration percentage based on the weight before and after the illness is 10% dehydration. The bolus of normal saline was given, which is 20 ml time the weight before the illness, 5.5, calculated to 110 ml were given. additional sodium needed to correct the hyponatremia, because you need to add more sodium to correct that to 130. So how to calculate that? By the weight time 0.6 time desired sodium minus the current sodium. So it will be 5.5 time 0.6 time 10 will be equal 33 mEq. The information we need to calculate the IV fluid for this patient: the weight before the illness is 5.5 kilogram and the current weight is 5 kilogram. So the difference is half kilogram, which is a 10% loss of the body weight. Therefore, the dehydration is 10% and the sodium is low. This is hyponatremic dehydration. The maintenance fluid based on holiday cigar method, 100 ml for the first 10 kilo. So the patient weight is 5.5 times 100 equal 550. And the sodium maintenance, 3 mEq per 100 ml of the maintenance fluid. So 3 times 5.5. 3 times 5.5 equals 16.5, and the potassium 2 times 5.5 will give you 11. So this is the maintenance for water, sodium, and potassium. For the deficit, this is a 10% dehydration, so 100 times 5.5 equals 550. For the sodium deficit, 8.4 mEq per 100 ml of the fluid deficit will be 8.4 times 5.5. Will be equal 42 mEq of sodium deficit. And the potassium 6 per 100 ml of the fluid deficit will be 6 times 5.5 equal 33. And the additional sodium need to be calculated, and we calculate that in the previous slide, and is 33 mEq. And the bolus was given need to be subtracted. 110 ml contains 16.9 of sodium, because 1000 ml contains 154 mEq of sodium. So the total for the water is 990, 550 plus 550 minus 110 equal 990. Divide that over 24 hours, the rate is 41 ml. For the sodium, add 16.5 plus 42 plus 33 minus 16.9. It will calculate to 76.4 mEq of sodium per 24 hours. And for the potassium, 11 plus 33 is 43 mEq per 24 hours. So you need to prepare a bag of 1000 ml and you round that to 40. And this one is 76, which is very close to D5.5. The half normal saline, it has 77 mEq of sodium. So the appropriate fluid for that is D5.5 normal saline plus 40 mEq of potassium chloride to run at 41 ml per hour over 24 hours. The shortcut of calculation of hyponatremic dehydration, the same case we had before. The weight is 5.5 kilogram and the patient weight during the illness is 5 kilogram. So 5.5 minus 5, so this is a 10% dehydration, and the sodium is low, is hyponatremic. So because this is 10% dehydration, you will give double the maintenance. And the fast way of calculating the maintenance, you use the holiday cigar method, 4-2-1. So 5.5 kilogram times 4 equal 22 ml per hour. Double the maintenance will be 44 ml per hour. And generally, all the cases, or most of the cases of hyponatremic dehydration calculated to D5.5 plus 40 mEq of potassium chloride, to and the rate here will be the double the maintenance will be 44 ml per hour. If you compare it to the case we calculated before, using the long way of calculation, is 41 ml per hour is the rate. So this is very close. So for this case, the rate is 44 ml per hour if you use the fast method of calculation. Hyponatremic dehydration conclusion: regardless of the presenting serum sodium value, when combining the maintenance and deficit water and electrolyte into one solution, this will end up in a calculation of D5.5 normal saline plus 40 mEq of potassium chloride. And the goal of correction always of the sodium not to exceed 12 to 15 mEq per liter over 24 hours. This is very important to keep in mind to avoid complications. General approach to cases of hypernatremic dehydration. First, you need to calculate the same like before, maintenance of fluid and electrolytes. The maintenance of fluid and electrolytes based in holiday Seeger method. And you will give that, you will time that by the 48 hours. So for the maintenance, you should give the maintenance for each day. And the electrolyte maintenance also for each day the same. But when it comes to the deficit, you calculate the fluid deficit by itself. Then you calculate the free fluid deficit. Free fluid deficit, and in the cases if the sodium is more than 145 and less than 170, you will use 4 ml per kilo for each 1 mic above 145. And for the cases more than 170, you will use 3 ml per kilo for each 1 mic of sodium above 170. Fluid deficit, again, you very important to get the fluid deficit containing electrolyte. So you subtract the fluid deficit you calculated minus the free fluid deficit. And in this case, you will have this volume. And according to this volume, you will calculate the electrolyte at this point. And the total fluid should be given over 48 hours, not 24 hours. So here the goal here is to correct the hypernatremia slowly, not fast. Clinical case scenario for calculation of hypernatremic dehydration. This is a 7 months old, has diarrhea for 3 days. Mother was giving boiled skim milk. He is lethargic and screams when touched. Laps back to somnolence. Kids with hypernatremic dehydration, they are somnolent, but when they are touched or try to wake them up, they are very irritable and they scream, different than kids with hyponatremic dehydration. The weight is 8.5 kilograms, heart rate is 180, blood pressure 52 over 28 millimeter of mercury, his skin is doughy. Compared to the hyponatremic or isonatremic, the skin is tinting and the mucous membrane is dry. Tear fontanelle and the eyes are normal, and this is expected in cases of severe hypernatremic dehydration, that the child may not look as bad as in cases of hyponatremic or isonatremic dehydration because of the shift of the fluid from the cells to the intravascular space. So these kids, they have late presentation because they do not look as bad as the other kids with isonatremic or hyponatremic dehydration. Serum sodium is 158. He is hydrated weight, or his hydrated weight is 10 kilogram. So his weight is 10 kilogram before the dehydration, and now is 8.5. So he lost 15% of his body weight. So the percentage of dehydration here can be calculated as 15%. So knowing the weight before the dehydration is very helpful. If it's not, you have to use your clinical assessment. And for this type of dehydration, you need to add another 3 to 5% if you do not have the weight to your clinical symptoms of dehydration. So he received 20 ml of normal saline per kilo as a bolus. The information we need to calculate the IV fluid for this patient is here. The weight before the illness is 10 kilogram. The current weight is 8.5 kilogram. 10 minus 8.5 is 15. Therefore, the percentage of dehydration is 15%. The current sodium is 158. This is hypernatremic dehydration. The maintenance fluid should be calculated for each day, then time 2 days. Based on holiday Seeger method, 100 ml per kilo, which is the first 10 kilo. The patient weight is 10 kilo, so 100 times 10 equal 1000, time 2 days is 2000 ml. For the sodium maintenance will be 3 mg per 100 ml maintenance, will be 3 times 20, will be 60 mg of sodium to be given over 48 hours, and 2 times 20 for the potassium, 40 mg of potassium to be given over 48 hours. Fluid deficit without electrolyte will be 150, because 15% dehydration time 10, the patient weight, equal 1500. The free water deficit, 10 kilogram time 4, time 158 minus 145, this will be equal 520. The fluid deficit containing electrolyte will be 1500, the fluid deficit 1500 minus the free water deficit. This will be equal 980. And the sodium deficit based on the fluid deficit containing electrolyte result will be 8.4 per 100 ml of this fluid, will be 8.4 times 9.8 equal 82.3 mEq. And for the potassium will be 6 times 9.8 will be equal 58.8. And the bolus given should be subtracted 200 ml for the water and 30 mEq for the sodium. The total fluid for the water needed is 2000 plus 1500 minus 200 equals 3300 ml. And divide that over 48 hours, the rate will be 69 ml per hour. For the sodium, 60 plus 82.3 minus 30 will be equal 108.4 over 48 hours. For the potassium, 40 plus 58.8 will be equal 98.8 mEq divide over 48 hours. But how to divide that, or how to give it in the IV fluid in 1000 ml bag? You need to divide 98.8 by the amount of the fluid in liters. So it will be 98.8 divided by 3.3 will be rounded to 30 mEq of potassium chloride. And the 108.4 divided by 3.3 will be rounded to 34, which is the quarter normal saline. So the IV fluid you will give D5 quarter normal saline plus 30 mEq of potassium chloride to run at 69 ml per hour over 48 hours. Critical information to learn about hypernatremic dehydration. Children with hypernatremic dehydration usually somnolent, sleepy, but when they are stimulated, they are very irritable, different than the kids with hyponatremic dehydration. The skin is doughy instead of tinting like isonatremic and hyponatremic dehydration. It is usually underestimated percentage of dehydration because of the shift of the fluid from the cells to the intravascular space. So you need to add 3 to 5% if you are using the clinical symptoms to calculate the percentage of dehydration. It is critical while you are correcting the hypernatremic dehydration to check the sodium level every four to six hours. And too rapid correction can cause cerebral edema and seizures. Fast correction of hypernatremic dehydration can be associated with seizure, and generally if to correct that you need to give 1 ml per kilo of 3% normal saline to increase the serum sodium by 1 mg per liter. Generally, if you give 4 ml per kilo of 3% normal saline, this will stop the seizure in most of the cases. It is very important to be familiar with other causes of hypernatremic dehydration. Diabetes insipidus is a very important cause of hypernatremic dehydration, and you should suspect that in any child is having hypernatremia, high serum osmolality and low urine osmolality. The common causes of diabetes insipidus is central or nephrogenic. Central can be idiopathic because of tumor or because of surgery. So it's very important to keep in mind, and nephrogenic diabetes insipidus is resistance to ADH or antidiuretic hormone. Very important to know the difference here in the cases of hypernatremic dehydration because of diabetes insipidus. All children with diabetes insipidus must have access to plain water all the time. As long as these children, they have healthy thirst center and a thirst sensation and the availability of plain water, they will stay alive. Treatment of central diabetes insipidus is vasopressin and replacement of free water. Finally, very important information to know about hypernatremic dehydration. It is a high risk of cerebral hemorrhage, thrombus, and edema. The calculated fluid usually calculated to D5 quarter normal saline plus 20 to 40 mEq of potassium chloride. The deficit replacement should occur over 48 hours. Very important that the deficit should be replaced over 48 hours. Your goal of correction of sodium not to exceed 0.5 mEq per liter per hour. Very important to keep that in mind. If you exceed this amount, the mortality and morbidity is very high. To summarize what we did before, isonatremic dehydration should be corrected over 24 hours. The ideal fluid to use is D5 third normal saline plus 40 mEq per liter of potassium chloride. This fluid may not be available in many centers, so you can use safely D5 half normal saline plus 40 mEq of potassium chloride can be used instead of D5 third normal saline. Do not use D5 quora normal saline for isonatremic dehydration. It's not appropriate. So the appropriate fluid level is either D5 third normal saline. This is choice number one if you are in the exam, if both available. And the choice number two is D5 half normal saline plus 40 mg per liter potassium chloride. If this is the only choice you have and you do not have this in your choices, you choose this answer for isonatremic dehydration. D5 have normal saline, and in real life, this is the most widely used fluid for isonatremic dehydration. Hyponatremic dehydration should be corrected also over 24 hours. The appropriate fluid usually used for that, or usually calculated to D5 have normal saline plus 40 mg of potassium chloride per liter. The hypernatremic dehydration should be corrected over 48 hours to prevent seizures and complications. So, and when it's calculated, the usually calculated to D5 quora normal saline plus 20 to 40 mg of potassium chloride. You cannot use the shortcut for this type of dehydration. It should be calculated exactly. Finally, the easiest and most simple way of calculating IV fluid rate for isonatremic and hyponatremic dehydration based on Holliday-Seeger method using 4-2-1 rule, 5% dehydration, 1.5 maintenance, 10% dehydration, double maintenance, 15% dehydration, 2.5, 2-3 maintenance. This rule do not apply to hypernatremic dehydration because of complication of rapid correction of sodium. So it has to be corrected over 48 hours. So you cannot use this method for hypernatremic dehydration. This lecture is only for educational purpose and is not intended to direct care of any specific patient. Please consult your physician and the physician of your child for the correct diagnosis and the proper treatment. None of my videos can be superior or an alternative for the opinion of experienced and licensed healthcare professional. Thank you again.